This series is proudly supported by the French National Center for Cinema. Hey guys, salut, this is Alex. So this is episode number 2 of the croissant series. I just bought a few ingredients from the grocery store. I especially went to like a common grocery store, not to get too specific straight from the start, because I want to start simple, okay? I want to see if I can do it with this. So let's start. Okay, so that will be the mixing and kneading done. The texture of the dough is quite smooth, it's soft. Oh, it's fun as well. Not sure this is a technical term, but whatever. Okay, it's now ready for its first proofing time. I'm gonna place it in the oven. Oh, the oven obviously is off, but I'm keeping the light on, so we're staying at around 30 degrees Celsius, which makes something in Fahrenheit. The dough is resting in the oven, it's proofing in fact. It's gonna stay in there for about 1 to 2 hours. The most important thing is that it has doubled in size at the end of this process, which means that it's gonna be ready to move on to the next step. This way. The dough is nicely puffed up. It's soft with a touch, but still it's bouncing back. It needs to be cold as balls before we work with it, basically. So in the fridge for at least an hour. In the first episode, I shared the basic theory of croissant dough, you know, the layering effect. Now I feel like as you're about to actually make that complex dough, you need practical information. Right, so to keep it simple, first you make that sandwich dough, okay? Which we're gonna call from now on the sandwich. And second, you're gonna fold that sandwich onto itself. Now there are two folds you could perform. The first one is called a simple fold, and it's basically folding the sandwich like this, which creates three layers. And the second one is called a double fold, and it basically folds the sandwich on itself like this. So four layers. Now of course, by combining those two, in fact doing this one first and then this one along the way, you get 4 times 3 layers at the end, so 12 layers. Now if you thought that there were more layers than 12 in a croissant, then you are right in fact, because that 12 layers dough is then rolled onto itself to form the final shape of the croissant, and so you've got several times those 12 layers. So it's like an exponential crispiness. Now, obviously, life would be too easy if things were called what they actually are, because the problem is that what I rightfully called a fold is in fact called by French pâtissier a turn. And when you spin the dough on itself, hence making the croissant, so you're turning the dough, they call this a fold. Yeah, I'm upset, but I'm not surprised, because for me, French pâtissiers have always been a bunch of perverts. Time to be practical, okay? I don't have a very specific recipe in mind. I've been watching a few online, but I think I've got the concept right, so I hope it's enough. Ah, man. used to make a cross shape. So the idea right there is to encapsulate a sheet of butter inside the dough. Let's measure the space we have inside. So I need a square, I need like a 22. So I would need about a 22 centimeter square. That's what I would need. Zing, zong, schlack. Good. Perform a single fold. So the dough has been resting for 15 minutes more. I don't need to fold it anymore, I just need to flatten it to 4 millimeters, which is gonna be something to do. About those croissants, to be I'm both super excited and super terrified. So I just coated them with an egg wash, which is basically an egg plus a tad of water. It's time to proof them a second time, which in French is called l'après. It should translate to close to being ready. I don't have any specific timing for this. I'm thinking maybe an hour, maybe 2 hours. I just want those croissants to have double inside before I actually bake them. Wow. It's beginning to look a lot like croissant. I'm gonna apply a second coating of egg wash just to be sure that we get this extra dark golden brown color at the end. Gonna be fine. Like, what could possibly go wrong in a recipe with like 1,000 variables? I'm not sure if I should be brushing the sides. I'm thinking yes if I want to. Sorry to interrupt, but I need your feedback on something. I am at the moment thinking about creating an online course about how to become a more confident cook in the kitchen. Something detailed and step by step. If that sounds interesting, there's a link in the description below to a quick survey that should help me build something more useful for you. Okay, back to the greasy business. They could probably be a bit longer, they could probably be a bit more uniform in terms of color. But to me, they're beauties. Bon, I'm afraid I'm not gonna eat them straight away just because, yes, it would be too easy to enjoy them while they are warm. I wanna enjoy my croissant at room temperature and so be able to tell if it's good or if it's bad. So I'm gonna clean the whole thing and you can just stare at those. Okay, I guess it's time. This one or this one? This one. Or this one. Plouf, plouf, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, c'est lui. Petit moment of truth. exactly smells like in a French bakery. Yeasty, buttery, milky, sweet. Yeah, I think I've spoken enough. I'm trying to come up with adjective. And I just want to stuff my face with this croissant. You've got a nice contrast between the outside and the inside. Super extremely crispy and flaky and delicate and fragile on top. And then inside it's quite moist, it's soft. It's buttery. I guess it all comes down to this very last part. My favorite among all croissant parts, the ear. This batch is very promising, super promising. So this is good, no question asked. Is this great? Sort of. I mean, I'm not sure about this, and I'm a bit afraid of something, which is there might be like a huge gap to get to the next step, and I'm not sure that I can get all the information I need, all the moves that I need to perform, like just using YouTube or recipes. I might need to get out there. Luckily for me, I live in Paris. There are plenty bakers. And this is one of the best bakeries I know. Let's go and talk to the baker. This is the back door entrance. Salut Erwan.
Comment tu vas?
Ça va?
Ça va?
Impeccable, ouais. Impeccable. Petite question. T'es d'accord pour m'apprendre à faire des croissants?
Tu veux apprendre à faire des croissants?
Ouais.
Allez.
Yes! C'est parti.